one of the players that the coach will count on coming and changing the game. And definitely the other player is Abdallah Juma. He's also one of the strikers that they have. He could come up with something if he's introduced. But they're missing Shomari Kapombe, their right back, young right back who plays also for the Tanzania national team. He gives them a lot of drive going forward. And without him today, it's been clear that they've lacked the impetus on the right side.
We've also seen some of the URA substitutes at the bottom of the picture just a few moments ago. Now there may be a chance coming up here for Sun Tzu.
Very good pass, you must say, but the reaction of Sun Tzu was not as electric enough for him to get to that ball as fast enough.
Well, maybe a chance coming up on the other side. The keeper is in loads of trouble here. Could have been punished, maybe should have been punished. And the all-important second goal goes a begging for URA. And an early goal for them could make a world of difference in the second half. Watch the keeper.
Oh, yes, sir. It can make a world of good for URA. It would have been if Saidi Cheyune had just breathed in a little bit and taken that shot without any rush, because that was the goal gaping, a very good gift given to him. And I just hope they don't throw this opportunity, this missed opportunity.
Well, URA, with the chance possibly coming up here, if the pace has got enough now. Is that a professional foul? That is the question. Looks as though the man was through with a sight on goal, and I think that's what some of the players are pointing out to the referee here. Little disappointed to see the yellow card shown when they felt it was a clear-cut goal-scoring opportunity. They're crying professional foul.
Well, I'm sure URA would think that Mafata should have been sent off, but at the end of the day, it's the referee's discretion. He also looks at the situation in which the tackle came. Was it really a cynical challenge, or it was some kind of tackle that came as a result of Mafata trying to move, also to run onto the ball? I just don't think he went all out to hurt Sentongo in this situation. But they've got to be careful, Simba, because URA has very good dead ball experts in Yayo Lutimba, even Sentongo himself, and also Simeon Masaba, the captain. They've got to be very careful, otherwise, and Owen Kasule himself is also a good free kick executioner.
So, URA look for an early goal here in this second half. The shot coming and caused a good save from Kasey Jamin, who made the mistake earlier on in this half, has made up for it at the expense of the corner.
Yeah, he was expected to stand up at that moment. After making the earlier mistake, you've got to show that you're there to be counted as a goalkeeper. And as a captain, you've got to pull up such saves like you just did a short while ago. But URA has just enjoyed up that second corner kick of the game. And let's wait and see what happens. As well, there's a bit of shark pulling from what I see in the picture.
Lisa Kagabo, the Rwandan referee, having plenty to do here. He has shown just one yellow card in this match. That came up just a few moments ago, and for Sabi
Sabiria,
Alex, he's hoping that his side can find their own important second goal. Ball in near post, well defended. They'll get yet another corner. He's looking a tad bit nervous.
Yeah, of course, one of the things he said, he can't wait for this game to be complete. He said that even from Kampala playing against Simba.
They get more distance on this corner. Fortunately, it does fly over everybody's heads. Unfortunately for URA, and Simba fans will be thinking, fortunately.
Suddenly.
So the first 5 minutes of the second half have absolutely flown by here.
Already seen two good goal scoring opportunities for URA. It shows you that the team with a purpose, and they know what brought them to Dar es Salaam. They want to finish off Simba and wait for the next opponent. But talking of Isabelis, you just said that he looked quite cagey, and surprised that he's not looking comfortable, yet his team is in the lead.
Well, he is a man of experience, and the assumption is he has plenty of experience under his belt, and he'll know, up against the side with the strength of Simba, you need more than one goal with so much time still remaining on the clock, quite possibly. Plus Simba had some good signs in the first half that they are capable of possibly finding the back of the net. The only thing that came between them and possibly a goal was Yasin Mugabe between the sticks. He was outstanding, as we pointed out on a few good occasions. Simba, the opening 6 minutes, been able to build the momentum here. At this point, Mr. Kakabo of Rwanda is having to work a little bit harder than he did in the first half, and you can expect things to get a bit more tense as we move towards the 1 hour mark and beyond that, especially with Simba in the chase. Now, URA still in search of that second. Looking for the yard then is Santogo. In the end, he is outnumbered and outputted.
Yeah, he didn't take the right decision. He should have released that ball quite early, but tried to dilly-dally and dribble. At the end of the day, he lost possession with that weak pass that he tried to play out to his teammate.
Sunzu is a big man. Not the greatest technically when it comes to skill and dribbles, but still working hard here, a man who's had very little service, but still has to point out, has worked his socks off. His movement off the ball at times was impressive in the first half. Able to pick out a teammate then was Kasimoto. Now Simba with a chance to maybe put some pressure on URA here in this second half. Oh, that's a beautiful ball. Lovely skill in controlling and turning then from Biavanga. Early ball, great run! Oh, super save! No, what maybe needed is that a penalty? Whistle's gone, the flag's up for offside then. But once again, Yasin Mugabe has come up with the goods after a lovely ball and maybe not the best of hitters, but a good chance, a great chance for Simba.
Well, Yasin Mugabe as a goalkeeper has been very impressive today. But you must condemn the way URA is defending in the second half, because you just can't keep giving us such opportunities like they just did. And it showed even in the first half, just at the tail end of the first half, that they were making so many clumsy decisions, and they could pay for it just the way they are playing in the second half. You just don't want to give Simba a lease of life. If Simba gets a goal right now, you never know what happens. This game could turn on its head.
Once again goes on to highlight the importance of a second goal possibly here for URA. But Simba enjoying possession. We'll know that they are the type of side with players out there that have the ability to create chances. Here's one of them, Kasimoto. Good ball and vision to the far side, and slowly they are getting men forward outside of your picture towards the edge of the area. So always inviting the early ball into the box. Ramadan. The turn of URA to have plenty of numbers back inside their own final third and winning back position. They don't hold on for too long. They have cover out on that far side with one man. Sunzu inside the box for the time being. Both these sides working extremely hard here as we round off the opening 10 minutes of this first half. An enjoyable game. If you are just joining us, stay with us on your World of Champions and those that have been with us from the very beginning. Thank you for doing so, and I hope you're enjoying this as much as we have been here this afternoon.
And the tempo of the game has gone up in the second half. You can see Simba is forcing the issue now. They are playing with a higher tempo now.
Ramadan. Sunzu always the first inside the box. He's looking to get out to the end of it. And an important touch from Mugabe. He's worked extremely hard. Another ball in, far post. Good work defensively. The goalkeeper's called for it, and Mugabe relieved the pressure off of his defense.
He's had a very good command of his penalty area, Mugabe. And you've got to give him credit for the way he's done his job as the goaltender. But you can see that Simba is now getting a foothold on this game. They're pressing more, and URA is seemingly more porous than they were in the first half. And I have a feeling that before we know it, Simba could get a goal.
Kasule, hoping to prove you wrong, John, and ensure that the next goal goes to URA. Here he is pulling the strings here, Kasule. Leg up against Santogo.
Good idea by Kasule, but Santogo ran off very fast and it was caught offside in that one.
Hails from the Villa Academy as we have a look at that decision once again. Just offside, tight one. And also played for Express and won the league with them. First official goal game it is for him.